Where are your grandparents from?
So my grandmama is my mum's mum. She is from Zambia.
Mm-hmm. Irish grandparents.
On my dad's side, if it gets a bit more complicated, they're from Seychelles, mm-hmm. and Seychellians have an Indian, Asian, African, and French.
Okay, yeah,
Nick. Yeah.
Someone in my family thinks there's like a royal link and that, oh no, the record's burnt down so you can't tell.
Eddie Izzard did a program years and years ago, which was terribly flawed.
Danny Dyer got super excited about
being
royalty or something.
And it was so sweet because obviously it meant a huge deal to him. But the thing is that we are all related to one another. It is simply a matter of degrees. So we are all related to royalty, every one of us. So I don't actually know huge amounts about my family background. I know that they basically come from Britain, and before that they're bound to have come from Northern Europe.
I should probably look into it, but I'm like, maybe I should do that when I'm older and have time.
I do one of those online ancestry things. 10% of me is from the UK, 10% of me is French.
I wonder what the accuracy is of that though, you know?
If there are kind of little family stories and you want to be able to test that out, sometimes the DNA can help you with that. What it does is it takes your DNA and it looks at little bits of it, and then it compares it to other people who are also in their database and sort of tells you populations you're most closely related to. And most people kind of know that just looking in the mirror.
How we calculate how many ancestors we have.
If it starts with you, you've got two parents, then they've got two parents each.
So that's your parents, and then their parents, so your grandparents.
Grandparents. Then one, two. Oh no, this is gonna get messy.
Do we have to do the maths?
No. We're gonna do the maths.
Going back 500 years is gonna give you 20 generations.
So on this one, so we have 2, we have 4, we have 8, and we have 16.
32. Generation 6, 64 for generation 7.
256.
512?
512.
Yeah.
I'm just going to write lots up here.
2 times 2 times 2.
So you have got two parents, or grandparents. It doubles every time. So basically you go 2 to the 20. So that's 2 times 2 times 2, 20 times. So you have got over 1 million ancestors.
Wow!
This is gonna not match up with the actual population they had back then, isn't it?
As you go further back in time, so you've got, you know, 2 parents, 4 grandparents, 8 great-grandparents, and so on back. So your tree is widening out like this, but the population simply wasn't that big.
But also, how do you, what's the...
Because you're not accounting for inbreeding.
Like at one point you didn't have 3 grandparents as opposed to 4.
So Darwin was quite worried about this because Darwin actually married his cousin. So he was quite interested in looking this sort of thing, wondering what was happening in terms of marrying, intermarrying within families like this. Because these people, this chap here has got, he's part of a first cousin marriage, instead of having the 8 great grandparents, he's only got 6. This is what's known as pedigree collapse.
Oh, gold star.
Everyone with blue eyes can trace their ancestor back to like one person.
That's the Adam theory, isn't it? Yeah.
Eve.
Oh, sorry, Eve. Is Adam not part of this?
There is a piece of DNA which is passed down virtually unchanged, and it comes down through the female line. We all carry it. It's known as mitochondrial DNA.
Which is like the powerhouse of the cell.
And so the genes are actually really, really quite conserved. And you can start to look at the diversity and start to work your way back and go, okay, so we know that the common ancestor for everyone alive today in terms of mitochondrial DNA lived in Africa somewhere around 200,000 years ago.